Is this new image to 3D artificial intelligence breakthrough set to beat Nvidia? For the first time ever, no matter the background, lighting, camera, or pose conditions, pictures can be instantly transformed into stunning high-quality 3D objects. Researchers from the University of Southern California and Snap Inc. have proposed a revolutionary method called neural rendering of objects from online image collections, which is based on neural radiance fields like those from Nvidia, but arguably even better. Recently, there is increased interest in using coordinate-based neural networks called neural fields to solve visual computing problems, such as synthesizing 3D shapes, animating the human body, and estimating pose. Neural radiance fields, known in short as NeRF, can synthesize high-quality novel views of static scenes from sparse calibrated images. While AI tools like Nvidia's NeRF has improved in quality and capabilities, there are still requirements that must be met, such as having fixed background and lighting conditions and recording multi-view images or video sequences in a single session. 3D object digitization techniques, which are used to isolate and capture the high-definition structure and appearance of objects from online pictures, are not often suitable for in-the-wild setups due to the variable backgrounds, illumination settings, and camera settings used to capture the individual photos. The AI researchers have proposed a novel approach called neural rendering of objects from online image collections to address the challenges of rendering high-definition 3D objects from pictures from widely varying circumstances. As input, this new AI model takes a small number of photos showing an object or its variations in different settings, plus a set of foreground masks defining the area of the object. The first step of the AI model involves calculating the object's geometry by learning a density field that indicates where there is physical content. This step uses two multi-layer perceptron functions to separately handle static and transient radiance data and to provide image-based supervision, then the camera parameters and posture predictions are calculated to refine the initial input. In the second step, the acquired geometry is finalized by extracting the surface normals of the object and adjusting the lighting parameters to re-render the object under different lighting scenarios. The surface normals are then used as supervision in the final step. And a four-layer multi-layer perceptron structure is used to generate the final surface normals, glossiness, base colors, and specularity. In a recent NeRF breakthrough for photorealistic 3D scene editing, AI researchers from Stanford University and Adobe Research have proposed PaletteNeRF as a novel method for easily and flexibly editing neural radiance fields. This new approach is based on earlier techniques for image editing that used color palettes, which use a limited set of colors to represent the full range of shades in an image. They describe the brightness of each point using a combination of specular and diffuse components, and further divide the diffuse component into a linear combination of common view-independent color bases. To minimize the difference between the generated images and the ground truth images, they jointly optimize the per-point specular component, the global color bases, and the per-point linear weights during training. To encourage sparsity and spatial coherence in the decomposition and create a more meaningful grouping, the authors also apply specialized regularizers on the weights. With this framework, users can intuitively adjust NeRF's appearance by freely altering the trained color bases. Additionally, they show how their system can be used in combination with semantic features to provide semantic editing. Their technique produces more globally coherent and 3D consistent recoloring of the scene across arbitrary viewpoints than previous palette-based image or video editing techniques. They demonstrate that their approach outperforms baseline methods numerically and subjectively, allowing for more precise local color modification while maintaining the photorealism of the 3D scene. While neural radiance fields and related techniques have gained popularity with their ability to accurately recreate 3D scenes from 2D photos, it was challenging to modify these volumetric representations before PaletteNeRF was available, because the scene appearance is encoded in the neural network weights, which don't allow for local manipulation or intuitive changes. Some methods were previously developed to support the editing of NeRF by recovering the scene's material qualities, such as surface roughness, or rendering the scene in new lighting conditions. But these techniques for modifying NeRF often relied on assessing the seam reflectance, which was very difficult for complex real-world images taken in an open environment. Another approach involved finding a latent code that NeRF could be trained to use to achieve the desired appearance, but these methods had limited flexibility and capacity and didn't facilitate fine-grained editing. Some other methods could adapt NeRF's appearance to fit a specific type of image, but they didn't always preserve the same level of photorealism as the original scene. Breakthrough artificial intelligence can generalize the navigation of any robot. Robots are becoming increasingly prevalent in various industries and settings, including healthcare, transportation, agriculture, construction, and even household chores. Despite their potential, robots still struggle with navigating various environments. Robot navigation involves developing algorithms and systems that allow them to move around and interact with their surroundings, but this can be difficult due to their diverse nature because each robot has its own unique design, with different camera locations, sensors, and movement capabilities. This makes it difficult to use machine learning methods for robot navigation, as it is not practical to create a large-scale dataset using only one type of robot. However, a large dataset is necessary for training modern machine learning models, as has been seen with the success of transformers in natural language processing and diffusion models in computer vision tasks. To address this challenge, the UC Berkeley researchers of the General Navigation Model, known as GNM, have proposed a solution: a general navigation model that can be used by any robot. By analyzing the necessary design decisions for effective data sharing across robots and demonstrating the benefits of using a heterogeneous dataset, the researchers were able to show that an omnipolicy trained from diverse data leads to robustness against degradation in sensing and actuation, and can be deployed on a range of new robots. It's been found that learning is a useful tool for computer vision-based navigation, but the capabilities of learning-based policies are limited by the amount of training data. By combining data from multiple sources, including different kinds of robots, AI researchers can train more powerful navigation models. The AI researchers study how a general goal-conditioned model for computer vision-based navigation can be trained on data from many different but structurally similar robots and enable broad generalization across environments and robot designs. They analyze the necessary design decisions for effective data sharing across robots, including the use of temporal context and standardized action spaces, and demonstrate that an omnipolicy trained from heterogeneous datasets outperforms policies trained on any single dataset. The AI researchers have curated 60 hours of navigation trajectories from 6 distinct robots and deployed the trained model on a range of new robots, including an under-actuated drone. They find that training on diverse data leads to robustness against degradation in sensing and actuation. By using a pre-trained navigation model with broad generalization capabilities, new applications on novel robots can be developed more easily. And the researchers hope that their artificial intelligence model will represent a step in that direction. The researchers' general navigation model has so far been shown to be a solid step towards effective data sharing among separate robotics devices, and so far seems to provide extremely promising results across various real-world settings, even when the robots are partially incapacitated with broken or faulty parts.